Being Human by C.S. Lewis. Angelic minds, they say, by simple intelligence, behold the forms of nature. They discern unerringly the archetypes, all the verities which mortals lack or indirectly learn. Transparent in primordial truth, unvarying, pure earthness and right stonehood from their clear. High heavens are seen, unveiled the seminal huge principles appear. The treeness of the tree, they know the meaning of arboreal life, how from earth's salty lap the solar beam uplifts it, all the holiness enacted by leaf's fall and rising sap. But never an angel knows the knife-edged severance of sun from shadow, where the trees begin, the blessed cool at every pore caressing us. An angel has no skin. They see the form of air, but mortals, breathing it, drink the whole summer down into the breast. The lavish pinks, the field new moan, the ravishing sea smells, the wood fire smoke that whispers rest. The tremor on the rippled pool of memory that from each smell in widening circle goes the pleasure and the pain. Can angels measure it? An angel has no nose. Far richer they. I know the senses witchery causes guards us like air from heavens too big to see, imminent death to man that barb sublimity and dazzling edge of beauty unsheathed would be. Yet, here, within this tiny charmed interior, this parlor of the brain, their maker shares with living men some secrets in privacy forever ours, not theirs.
Thank you.
Not Today by Chelsea Ballmer. Blueberry stains on my fingertips, pancakes scooped up by hand. The windows are open throughout. Cool breeze clears out the smoke. Thunderstorm's done for today. A Lady in Her Tower by Paul Verlaine. A saint in her halo, a lady in her castle tower, all that which contains the human words of grace and love. The golden sound that is heard of a horn in the distant forest, joined with the tender pride of noble ladies of long ago. With that, the distinguishing charm of a fresh, triumphant smile hatched in the guilelessness of the swan and the blush of the woman child. Of appearances pearly, white, and rose, a soft patrician bearing, I see and hear all these things in her Carolinian name. Thank you. The Drenched Garden by Henri Regnier. The casement is open. The rain falls, minutely, as it were, noiselessly and gradually on the fresh and sleeping garden. Leaf by leaf, the rain awakens the dusty tree, turning it green. The climbing vine against the wall seems to stretch lethargically. The grass trembles. The warm gravel crunches, as though over there you could hear on sand and grass the sound of indistinguishable steps. The garden whispers and quivers, furtive and confiding. Stitch by stitch, the downpour seems to weave together earth and sky. The rain falls, and I, with closed eyes, listen. As with all its rain at once, the drenched garden drips in the shadow I've made in myself.
Thank you.
Elves by Le Comte de Lisle. Crowned with thyme and marjoram, the joyous elves dance on the plain. From the woodland path known by the deer, on black horse emerges a knight. His golden spur gleams in the dark night, and as he passes through a moonbeam, one sees shining a changing reflection on his hair, like a silver helmet. Crowned with thyme and marjoram, the joyous elves dance on the plain. They surround him in a waking swarm, which seems to hover in the mute air. Bold knight, on this serene evening, where are you going so late? Says the young queen. Evil spirits haunt the forest. Come dance instead on the fresh grass. Crowned with thyme and marjoram, the joyous elves dance on the plain. No, my fiancée, with her eyes sweet and clear, waits for me, and tomorrow we will marry. Let me pass, elves of the plain, who walk in circles on the flowery moss. Do not keep me far from my love, for already the glimmers of day are here. Crowned with thyme and marjoram, the joyous elves dance on the plain. Rest here, knight. I will give you the magic opal and the golden ring and that which is better than glory and fame. My dress spun from the moonlight. No, he says. Go then. And with her white finger, she touches the warrior's heart. crowned with thyme and marjoram, the joyous elves dance on the plain. From beneath the spur, the black horse bolts. He runs, he leaps, and leaves without slowing. But the knight shivers and sways. He sees on the path a white form who marches without noise and reaches out its arms. Elf, spirit, demon, do not stop me! Crowned with thyme and marjoram, the joyous elves dance on the plain. Do not stop me, odious phantom. I will marry my love with her sweet eyes. Oh, my dear husband, the eternal tomb shall be our wedding bed. She says, I am dead. And he, seeing her thus, from anguish and love, so too falls dead. Crowned with thyme and marjoram, the joyous elves dance on the plain.
Thank you. want to say thank you all so much for coming. I really hope that you've enjoyed this combination. And after I am done with this last song, there's a recital at 10, and I've gone a little over because of what I have chosen to do. So if we could all, if you want to say hi after, I would love to do that, but if we could go out to the lobby to give the next person some time, that'd be great. Thank you, and I hope you enjoy.
The Nightingale by Deborah Henson Conant. Who will sing for the nightingale when the night is gone, when the daylight comes? Who will sing for the nightingale when she sleeps alone in the sun? Many's the time her silken tone soothed my rough and weary bones. Many's the time her lullaby brought me to my rest. But who will sing for the nightingale? Her own sweet song is silent now. Who will sing for the nightingale when she sleeps alone in the sun?